so when you have a variable times a variable, you know you have a product rule going on. Alright, so I'm going to use their letters, h prime and b equals. So I'm going to keep the first. What's the derivative of tangent? Look at your answer choices. It better be secant squared, right? Alright, and then I'm going to keep the second, which is the tangent of b. What's the derivative of the first? 5 to the 4th. Are that one of our choices? Yeah, I'll get slash b. Is that one of our choices up there? Yeah? Okay. Slash that one, sorry. Alright, there it goes. Alright, what do you guys want to, what else do you guys want to see from the first 25? 9?
5.
5. 9 to 2. Alright. Oh yeah, this is a good one, right? This is one of the AP exam's favorites. I also kind of like these. I especially like the derivative in here. This one just a little bit. So if it's continuous, that means it goes to the same number, right? It always goes to it'll come out to the same number. So I basically am looking at plugging this number in on both sides. So I'm really looking at the limit as x approaches 0 of 12 sine x over x, and setting that equal to the limit as x approaches 0 of a plus 5x. So what are we supposed to be putting in for the x? 0. What does sine x over x go to? 1. You have to know that. You need to know your trig derivatives, and you need to know the limit of sine x over x is 1. Probably not going to see the one with the memorized cosine. Almost always this one. Okay. So this first side ends up equaling 12, doesn't it? And then if I put a 0 in there, I get a plus 5 times 0, which is just a, so it has to be just a 12, right? Alright, what else do you guys want to see? 18? Okay, gotta use the quotient rule. It actually tells us that it may or may not. I didn't pull all my answer choices on that one. But what's the quotient rule say? Low d pi, what's your low? Good. Derivative of pi. 2, good. Minus pi d low. What's pi? 2t derivative low. 2t. 3t, sorry, 3t squared. Alright, and then all over the low
square.
Okay. I don't see any of my choices yet. Maybe let's see what happens if we, I deleted it, so I don't have all the choices up there. So I just one of the choices up there. Minus 16. No, it's not even, we need to get that in there. 16. You probably should distribute the 2 as well. Okay, so if I distribute 2t cubed plus 20, right? So what's 6 or 2t cubed minus 6t cubed? Negative 4t cubed, which is 2 factors. I'm going to format it like that. Does the denominator work, or does the denominator matter? No, it's always going to be that same square thing. Alright, so whatever squared. We said negative 4t cubed and 20. What's the greatest common factor there? 4, but look at what they're pulling out. They're only pulling out a 2, so let's try pulling out just a positive 2 and see what happens. So I'm seeing 10 minus 2t cubed. Is that one of our choices? Is that okay, I don't see this as an answer choice. The E was 2, negative 10, negative 2. So what's our other option? Pull out a negative, so that's going to swap this to a negative and make that go positive. So that looks like D, right? Okay. So you have to watch for those little algebra tricks. The calculus wasn't the problem, right? It's that stupid little algebra trick right at the end. Okay. All right, Alright, what else? Nine. Okay. My equation line is tangent to the graph and parallel to the given line. Okay, so tangent line and tangent equation, what two things do we need? Well, if you've learned nothing else this whole semester, hopefully you know that. Alright? Alright, so do I have a point? No. Do I have a slope? Not really, right? I know that the slope's either 24 or negative 24, but I've got to figure that out. Okay? So notice this find an equation. That might come into play here in a second. To get slope, how do we get slope? Derivative. Okay, so f prime of x equals what? 8x. That still didn't give me the slope, but it said something that has to be parallel to this line right here. So I'm going to get this line of y equals mx plus 2 by moving the y over. So y equals 24x plus 2. So what's the slope? 24. So we know it's probably not c or d. Okay? So but how would I get the point if I know this is slope and this is slope? So it's equal to each other. So what's the x value in our point? 3. How do we get the y value? We got to plug it into this right here, right? F of 3 equals 8 times 8, sorry, not, I'm using the wrong place. Alright. It is 4 times 3 squared. What's 3 squared? 9, so we get 36. Okay, then we go y minus the y value equals the slope times x. Secant's next in line, so there's a secant. Secant I do the secant, I leave the inside alone. I do the tangent, I leave the inside alone. So I have this 5, 5, 2 minus 2 thing inside. Is that good, right? Okay, we can handle it. All right. What is, so my innermost function is this 5 pi t, what's the rule of that? 5 pi is 5 and pi are numbers. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in front. 5 pi times that 8. All right, now we got to clean it up. So what's 5 pi times 8? 40 pi. Secant times secant is what?
Secant squared.
So they're making it fancy now, right? And then tangent just hangs out here at the end. How do I get the 5 pi front? The innermost chain rule was here. Your 5 pi times 5 pi. All right?
Whatever's left behind.
Okay? So what is the numerator factor into?
F minus.
Okay.
another 7. And another 7.
Okay, so it's lucky, it's the lucky problem. Alright, let's try it.
What did you get for the
15th and 16th? In this, I basically took, I saw the denominators were all 32 and 64, so I made a common denominator. Okay. I could have reduced this one, right? I made the common denominator 32. So I just found the common denominator. Yeah, that's the algebra and mathematics piece, the derivative part was easy, right? Yeah. The other part was easy. And again, I won't give you numbers out of the other final. All right. then Monday we'll.